So, since the last video, I made a rather disturbing discovery based on an offhanded comment somebody made that prompted me to look into what's referred to the XML files for the game, which is sort of like the data instructions tables slash instructions the game reads from to determine things. If you're a programmer, please try not to kill me over that inaccuracy. I program as well, but I'm trying not to get into a bunch of technobabble here. Point is, the game is apparently divided into very discrete stages for loot. And it's possible I'm wrong about all of this, but if I'm wrong, it's because the developers basically wrote, this is how this works, and here are the information, and then decided not to use it in the file for the loot determination. So, seems unlikely, but if you are between levels 1 and 32, the average loot quality you find is 94. Between 33 and 64, it is 118. Between 65 and 96, it's 158. Between 97 and 128, it's 242. And then between 129 to 160, it's 295, and it goes up from there. Now, you can add on another 150 or so from Quality Joe plus scavenging on top of that. But rather than discuss it in those terms, let's phrase it in a different manner. What are the odds we find a level 301 plus quality item? Which, so then that can be added on to saying, from Quality Joe and such, right, saying, what are the odds of finding a 451 plus quality item? Well, below level 33 is a 1% chance. Below level 64, level 65, there's a 1% chance. Below level 97, there is a 1% chance. It's not until you hit level 97 that you go from a 1% chance to find a 301 plus quality item, that becomes the 451 plus, right, to a 38% chance. 1% to 38%. When you go from level 96 to 97, or possibly 95 to 96, it's not quite clear how they're trying to have it read the data. So, I think I discussed about doing more looting today, but new plan is to make sure I get to level 97 before I resume looting, because that is apparently completely ridiculous if the breakpoint is that severe, that binary. But that's apparently what they're doing. So we were mining stuff. Wonder how high our gunsmithing was. Only 69. Level 84. See, a new rule of thumb is it's kind of pointless to go loot until you're level 97, possibly 96. High gravel. We're out of torches, though. That's annoying. Looking for the iron and potassium nitrate, or nitrate powder. Lead would probably go on for like eternity at this point. I am also guessing, but, you know, we'll attempt to verify later on, that finding like rare schematics or things like calipers is probably dealt with in a very similar fashion as well. Now, I will say that back in Alpha, I think 13 or so, maybe slightly earlier than that, the loot was a much more simple formula along the lines of, you know, your character's level times 10 plus or minus 50. And you might be guessing the level progression itself was also slower back then. I'm still kind of trying to come to grips with this realization to some degree. It's like, it is just so freaking pointless to be scavenging until level 97. Well, we have weaponsmithing and toolsmithing and all that sort of stuff that we can be doing. In another game with some of the friends that you heard me talking to at various points, I've managed to get up to 100 and level 26. And it is agonizing trying to get more XP at this point. Knowing what I know now, I'm pretty much falling into the thought of, like, never read schematics until you're at 100 in the appropriate skill. Unless you can do it at, like, you know, while you're at 5 in the appropriate skill or something. You just lose way too much potential XP reading it later on. And I am at the point where I've, like, maxed gunsmithing, I've maxed weapon crafting, I've maxed toolsmithing, I've maxed mining tools, I've maxed science, I've maxed several other things. I'm like at 70 plus in several other skills. And it is agonizing right now trying to just get up to, trying to hit that level 128, 129 mark, whichever it is, and see how much of a difference it actually makes. Yeah, I don't know. I really, really don't know. And to be clear, this does not even personally affect me all that much. I already tend to be quite the level grinder, etc., too. Be maximizing things, and the level 128 mark seems a bit much compared to what that's requiring to try to obtain, but overall, it doesn't affect me by that much. I mean, obviously, if you see here, if I haven't wasted a bunch of time and fiddled around with a bunch of stuff, I could easily be level, you know, 97 at this point. I don't know. Oh, nice. Our main base isn't even back till here. Nice. I was thinking that was part of the base, but no, we're still well away from that potential issue. Perfect. So, let's go work on, say, weapon crafting. And when I say work on weapon crafting, here's what I mean. Yes, we're literally sitting here. doing nothing, in a sense. Or rather, we're earning weaponsmithing skill from spamming out iron arrowheads, and we are earning gunsmithing skill by having 10 minutes more of gunpowder to be crafted. So we're double dipping, in effect. I think we might have done a little bit of power leveling with anvils, I don't remember. We'll probably do a bit more of that at some point as well, but the nice thing about the arrowheads is they are a lot more convenient to get rid of, because you can just stack them up to, you know, they stack up to 500. You can just put them right in the input and just have them smelt down over time, and that 500 arrowheads is equivalent to 1,000 iron in the forge, which is equivalent to 5 anvils, like stacks, and you can't stack anvils to 5. Hey, 7 weaponsmithing skill, hurrah, huzzah. So we have plenty of, oh, I'd say wood, but I mean wood log spikes to burn on this forge. We might need to harvest more in general. We do have all those trees that have grown, I think, though, right? So, not going to be too bad. I'm also thinking I'm going to start working on a tunnel from this base over to the town we were looting, because it is much larger than I anticipated, which is great! That means it might be convenient to have a tunnel going over there, so that'll be another project we'll be working on. I get why they wanted to not give infinite XP for one particular thing, that, because you no longer get any XP unless it gives you a skill up, right? Which means that they don't, like, I can get them not wanting you to say, oh, hey, I'm going to spam wood log spikes forever and keep continuous gain XP like you could in Alpha 13. Well, mainly gravel in those days, because you had so much small stone. But this new thing where you lose XP if you ever learn a schematic, and you're even more harshly punished in terms of overall XP possible if you learn it closer to 100 skill. Definitely not thrilled with that paradigm. .14.6 also changed the fixer skill in a very negative manner. Originally, people were complaining about how, you know, you can fix everything you find with 5 out of 5 to fixer, no matter what your skill is. And in all fairness, I don't necessarily disagree that perhaps that's a bit much. So, you know, what I suggested as an alternative, though honestly, since you already need schematics to repair things, you have to find the item at high quality in the first place. Most of the stuff you want to repair you can't craft anyway. If you can craft it, it's generally just as easy to create a new one. And it's like, I didn't really think it was that big of a deal, but it's like, okay, so if you're worried about it that much, how about this? How about we have the fixer work additively? Where let's say, you know, you change it instead of 5 ranks to 3 ranks, and if weapon, at the time, I think you could get minus 90% repair quality loss, which was then changed to like minus 83% now in Alpha 14, or maybe 14.6, I don't recall which. But, you know, minus 90% loss, okay, so then you need 1 rank of the fixer to 10% bonus, and you get 100%, you know, repair quality loss negated. But what if you're not at 100 skill? Well, then maybe if you were only, like, say, 85 skill, you have an 80% loss, so you need 2 ranks in the fixer. Or maybe you are only at 60 skill, so you need 3 ranks in the fixer. And so you invest in the fixer to be able to repair items without losing quality earlier. Gaz seemed to like that kind of idea that myself and a few other people discussed, and talked about how that would probably be how it got changed too. And then all that happened in Alpha 14.6 is that it got its data multiplicative bonus, meaning that it's like, let's say you're going to lose 10 quality naturally. If you had 4 out of 5 the fixer and before Alpha 14.6, then it'd be like, okay, so 10 quality loss times 0.8 is 80% negated, so you only lose 2 quality, but you're still losing quality. You're going to have to, you lose effectiveness over time anyway. So it's like, at that point, if you have to replace it anyways, is it that big of a difference between 10 and 2? I mean, it's still going to be reasonably useful until it hits like 500. Probably technically useful after that if you have to. But by that point, either way, you're hoping that you'll have found something better. So... but now it's a 50%, so if instead of losing 10 quality, you lose 5. Whoop-dee-doo! And literally, that happens to be the exact number, by the way, 5. If you have a 600 quality tool with max fixer and max toolsmithing, you will lose 5 quality per repair. It's like, okay, maybe we'll repair it with one steel bar a time or two for convenience, but really? It's super cheap to make a new freaking tool in the first place. We don't really care about having to spend a few more steel. Not when they last as long as they do anyway. And until your max skill level anyway, you'll probably want to be making new ones just to continually gain skill ups, right? So I don't understand the logic. What, 6 weaponsmithing we've gained already? Up to level 87. One exception I might make is running back to the town and trying to loot some clothing drawers. I'm trying to find a miner's helmet. That would be useful, and I don't really care what the quality is. I don't recall if I've mentioned one of the friends I have who is very much an explorer type. He doesn't really, and he doesn't mind helping construct bases, but he doesn't like mining extensively or mass gathering or that kind of stuff. He doesn't mind helping a little bit, but he hates like grinding stuff out. And Alpha 14 for him is just... I mean, to some degree, it might not bother him so much. But I know that there's another friend who's basically not not wanted the other friend to play with her in one particular game because she was afraid he was going to go around and loot all of the like unique stuff around her that she had been saving until she got to higher level, and thus if he looted it, she couldn't, and she'd lose out on the better loot and higher quality loot because the other guy hadn't bothered to level because he just liked to roam around and loot. Explore. And I think it's stupid that a game's resulting in that outcome. And the kicker is that I don't actually really blame her for feeling that way, because I, in all honesty, feel the same way too. Thank you. Which is doubly hilarious because the first friend, the explorer guy, he actually has a blog. Which is how we met in the first place. And in it he was talking about one of the things how he loved about 7 Days to Die is that it didn't punish you for having people with differently aligned goals. For example, in something like World of Warcraft, if anyone's familiar with that, yeah, I used to be quite a hardcore raider. Created and led my own guild for about the past 5 years. It fell apart last fall due to some really ridiculous drama in a way that I've never even heard of or seen before, which still has me a bit befuddled overall. Let's set something else up here. So we do have cloth chest armor, yes, cool. Which admittedly is one of the reasons I've been looking at some other games like 7 Days to Die, because I wasn't really feeling like playing a bunch of WoW there. There weren't really... one of the things about the guild I had is that it was a two-night-a-week guild. We only raided 2 nights a week. Nearly everyone else at our skill-slash-progression level, they were raiding 3, 4, 5-plus nights a week, and we were saying no. I was saying, I founded the guild to say no, we're just gonna only have to dedicate 2. 2 nights a week, that's it. You can have a life outside of the game. Problem is that there's very few guilds that are similar. So after my guild collapsed, even if I had wanted to, there weren't any other guilds at the progression level I wanted, the amount of time dedication needed that I wanted, for me to really do anything. Maybe I'll play again at some point, I don't know, I'm still trying to come to terms with some of the stuff that happened. But I met this guy, we were both playing WoW at the time through his blog, and he talked about, on 7 Days to Die, that one of the things he liked about it is that it didn't punish people, right? Because in the WoW raiding, if you have 9 people who are really wanting to be very serious about raiding and play a specific way, and you have the last person doesn't, well, that last person is going to hurt the group as a whole, because you can only have a certain number of people. You know, it's designed for 10 people. You can't bring an 11th person to chip in however they want. 7 Days to Die, though, you obviously can. Adding another person generally never hurts you. Especially in Alpha 13. I mean, worst case, they take a little bit more food and water that, you know, they can help gather if necessary without... Them gathering just enough food and water for themselves isn't really that difficult to do. And then beyond that, you know, anything else they contribute is generally just gravy. But now with the set of Quality Joe requiring 10 scavenging, and then you could buy all 3 ranks, and if you were like level, let's say 20 with max Quality Joe, you're always going to at least be pulling like 300 quality items on average. And it's pretty easy to hit at least level 30. I mean, you can certainly argue you progressed too fast overall in levels and etc. in Alpha 13. I'm not even necessarily going to disagree with that. I think the pendulum has swung too far in the other direction, though. Where I shouldn't feel like, God damn it, that friend is going to go out and loot the stuff around us, and I really don't want him to, because we need to stay in level grind first. If I wasn't recording, I'd just be reading a book or checking stuff on my phone here. Less than thrilling gameplay, though, obviously. And yes, the timer is still kind of borked. 8 seconds to go! Not. It's probably going to be another, like, 15 seconds. How about that? Pretty accurate, huh? I predicted negative 10, and that's exactly what it clipped off at. I should really make another building supply crate to store some of this. I just have so much. And again, because of the whole level grinding aspect, you're heavily encouraged to gather all this shit now and then sit on it and be able to use it, like, indefinitely or whatever. Well, we can be upgrading to the steel, I suppose. Grab some concrete in case we need to repair anything. Also, apparently each of these full, not the individual hits from the stone axe, but the actual switching over of the block to the next type of block, that is the only thing that gives experience, and it only gives experience based upon the actual switchover. It doesn't matter what material it is. It took me the same number of hits to reach, you know, the same amount of XP for wood and cobblestone. You know, which meant the cobblestone took 2/3 as much because it's 3 hits, you know, to upgrade the frame, whereas wood is like 2, well, not 2 hits, but 2 stages. So it's 3 stages for cobblestone, 2 stages for wood. So that we're building in steel or concrete doesn't matter. Makes no difference. Might as well just fill up a, spam out a bunch of wood frames and upgrade them. Also Horde Night, as you might recall. If it wasn't obvious, I waited to come out here until that screamer died, since now I know we have a few minutes before the next one. You know, it's nice if I could actually see some of this. I know some of those down there are concrete. Those are the ones I'm trying to upgrade. Thinking back to A13, where due to the insanely slow melting of stone and needing over 3 times as much for concrete, and concrete being better than it is now, kind of absurdly strong in all fairness, I don't disagree with, making it a little bit weaker from 12,000 to 9,000, and steel only added 4,000, so it's a bit of why bother? Why bother having to use steel when you're only going up 33%, or 25%, sorry, not even 33. 25% bonus. Now, though, you go from 9,000 to 19,000, which is a bit more of a difference, you know? Of question we now face is, how are we doing on food and water? We have plenty of both. More chrysanthemum or goldenrod wouldn't hurt, but we have a bunch prepared, so I'm not too concerned right now. That's all melting just fine. Didn't notice we were done with these. Let's scrap those. I suppose we actually should make some new arrows, shouldn't we? I don't know. If we're not going to make a crossbow, period, because we won't learn the recipe until 600 weaponsmith and skill. Let's make a bunch. This now goes into bronze, not a brass. We're good on this for the moment. You know what? We're gonna upgrade like the first level down. If that's already, is that concrete? Not in this game. Well, we'll be after this. And each time the block upgrades to the next stage, we get another chunk of experience. Looks like we have the maps. We're not using them for a pressing reason. We have a bunch of mining and stuff to do anyway, so I'm just burning through them. Next time the screamer comes, I'm going to head back outside and set up a few more things. Torches for better visibility. I assume when we get one before nightfall, otherwise why? Not gonna really be worried about it. Do we have any torches available someplace, maybe? Or did we burn through all of those? We can easily make more. I'm just trying to remember if I set aside a stash of them someplace. Looking like a no. Alright, I already put the wood back, that's why torch is not lighting up. I've actually only more recently in the game gotten into such serious subterranean mining, and I admit I didn't realize before just how like inconsequential lead was to be worried about on the surface given how much you can get down below. Might need to tear that chunk of ladder down again to upgrade to reforge to the steel, but we need to let this obviously dry. It's part of the catch. Looks like we might have to punt on our idea for more torches outside. One more chest piece to go. If For anyone wondering, the wood itself is only 500, I think, total. The iron has like 2250 total, but even the wet concrete still here is 1500. So, it's still plenty sturdy. I wouldn't want to use it as the main wall, then it's as weak as cobblestone. But in terms of if it takes an incidental hit or five, eh. Turn off our forges. Hey, there's the screamer. There dies the screamer. Howdy, boys. And girls, and girls. I admit I find it kind of hilarious when they like spin crazy like that. It's like, what in the world prompted them to have them do that? Sometimes they just flat out defy the laws of physics like that. What is up with that guy's neck? Look at that. Look at that. Thank you. and 11 up after you get up to one. I'm really not playing that well right now, am I? Yeah, kill that stone. Kill that stone. That stone's evil. Go zombies. Break the stone. Oh, there was a zombie hiding in the stone. I knew they were clever. Look at that. Whirl, 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 whirl. Stop whirling. Resume whirling. Whirl, 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 whirl. Stop whirling. Seem to be clear. I might be wondering, why didn't I run? Answer being that I wound up not doing as well as I meant to there, to be absolutely clear. If you're going to pop, like, I didn't want to risk, I wasn't sure if this was even completely in one piece, and didn't want to try to risk it not being available, so I thought better to just take a hit or two. Ideally hit the dog before it gets there, but if I screwed up and missed like I did, doesn't help with the terrain being so uneven right now. Oh, hey, wow. Thank you, zombies. F is flashlight, if you're not familiar with that. One thing I definitely don't like about the new looting system is it keeps basically making you pick up stuff you don't want to be freaking picking up. Like, when you finish looting something, it falls to the floor. Oh damn, 578 hazmat. Talking so much because I'm trying to make sure I can listen. I guess another dog bounds up out of nowhere like that. I see all these pockets of deformed terrain. Something we're probably going to be addressing this next week. Remember what I said about having the forges off so we didn't attract any screamers? This is another reason why. Business that. So look how deformed this all is. We definitely want to try to fix that for next week. Oh no, part of our steel wall went down nearly... That section nearly lost 10%? No, no. Obviously all the spikes we had are cleaned out. By the way, they also nerfed the survivor in a really dumb way. People are like, okay, so the first way you get a bit more wellness, the first point, then the second one you get 80% bonus, then 12%, you know, the second rank of this 12% bonus, Third ranks still a 12% bonus. Fourth and fifth ranks start to decrease, and at rank five out of five, you don't actually gain overall wellness. It just saves some food. I'm like, okay, we'll fix the progression to be more sensible. Guess what? Now every rank does nothing but just save you some food. Wait, what? Maybe it's all the bodies from the horde. Maybe those actually make... That's my best guess right now. I'm really not sure. No, I'm not bothering to deal with her until morning. She mad. Full marks for persistence, but question is this going to be considered a science item or miscellaneous crafting? I'm guessing miscellaneous, but we will see if this actually gives us any kind of bonuses to science. Yeah, miscellaneous crafting. Well, that's annoying. On to the next video.